Aggretsuko is my favorite anime of spring 2018 so far. Man, saying that out loud just feels wrong, but it's true, what can I say? I really enjoyed this show, and I'm not a big fan of the slice of life genre, nor am I an avid consumer of Sanrio products. I know, it's shocking. But me, a 25-year-old white man from the States, does not own a Hello Kitty plushie.
I have an Einz plushie. And how are you doing today, Einz? Is the sun not treating you well today? Speak to me, you imbecile!
To give you the quick and dirty, Aggretsuko is about a Red Panda office worker who deals with the stress of her crappy job by chugging beer and singing death metal in a karaoke parlor. That is straight from IMDb, there's nothing else going on here. And when you think about it, yeah, I guess overall it's not that interesting. But execution is the bread and butter of a mundane storyline, and execution is one thing that Aggretsuko nails. The animation is snappy and expressive, each character has a wide emotional range, and the comedic timing is on point. But from a design standpoint, Aggretsuko is another beast entirely. As you'd expect from the people that gave us marketable diabetes, the character designs for this show are amazing. Calling them cute doesn't begin to describe it. These characters are peak marketability. It's genius. If you played this in Walt Disney's cryo chamber, he'd probably resuscitate himself. Think of the money!
I am back to reap the benefits of good character design.
Oh my gosh. They have a 950 snapback? I shouldn't. It's so cute, though.
No. Stop!
No! The characters are also competently written, and no one is quite a paper-thin cutout. Even the boss, who's portrayed as the literal embodiment of patriarchy, gets some much-needed development by the end of the story. I guess you could say that, overall, the draw of Aggretsuko is that it is relatable. For example, Retsuko is 25, single, hates her job, but keeps it because she needs to pay rent.
Oh my gosh.
I get that the show is marketed to adults, but did you have to hit every nail on the head? Jeez, calm down. But to expand on the relatability thing, anything, and I mean anything, could be relatable. That doesn't make it worthy of your time. I mean, Owl Turd's comics can be relatable, but you're not gonna see me make a video telling you to read them, are you? That's because Pigeon Gazette is best girl. Read Pigeon Gazette. You bastard. In order for something hashtag relatable to hold any water, it needs an absurd or ridiculous angle on life. Enter death metal, Aggretsuko's gimmick. It's a gimmick, sure, but it's funny. At the same time, it's something that she's kind of ashamed of and doesn't want anyone to know about. And at the end of the day, everyone has a shameful slash not so shameful hobby that they use to blow off steam. Some beat it to ponies, others edit hour-long tirades on why Handshakers is the worst anime ever.
It's too much for one man to handle alone.
The show is 10 episodes long, 9 of which are 15 minutes long, the finale is 18. I won't say it'll fill you up, but it's a nice snack that you can digest on the way to work and in between the meat of the current anime season. I said it was my favorite so far, and it is. It warmed my soul. It isn't masterpiece material, but it isn't trying to be. It stays in its lane, and I think it's definitely worth a try. Netflix did a good job on this one, and they managed to make a light, short-length show that is unique, charming, and funny without sacrificing polish. They even managed to do an English cover of Retsuko's death metal pieces. Yes! Now, go back and get Logic or one of the many weebs in the rap industry to dub the crybaby raps.
I will be accepting late work for partial credit. Chop chop, Netflix! Chop chop!